discussing why you are learning Python. Number of times I try to tell you the why you are learning Python. Python is not meant for whatever you are teaching to you right now, because we are now teaching you the basic the syntax of Python, but Python is 10 times slower than Java. Okay, definitely 10 to maybe 5 times slower than Java. Java is again maybe 10 times or 5 times slower than C, C++. So why we are learning this thing, Python? There is the trick why we are learning Python. Because main reason of Python learning, that it gives the power of Java and power of procedural programming, like C++. See, Java, the only fault is, it is one of the problem is Java is purely object-oriented programming. You cannot write procedural programming. And what is the difference of procedural programming and object-oriented programming? We learn today. We try to learn today because both are necessary. It is not that procedural programming is better or object-oriented programming is better. There are pros and cons, and there are another type of programming, there are functional programming, command-level programming. All these things we'll little bit discuss. Python gives you all the feature in a open-source programming library. And Python main strength is third-party library. We'll come to that. So what is the Python for? Python, that I told you whenever teaching you, that Python, your program looks nice. It should look nice. In C, whether you are giving gap and all, doesn't matter. In the Python, basic syntax is depends on white space. Because there is white space means it's a signal. It is a syntax, like they don't have semicolon, so they didn't have full stop like COBOL or Fortran or like this. That semicolon is the main end of sentence, like in C, C++, Java, whatever you learn. So Python doesn't maintain. It's a white space. That is even a tab is very important. C++ it doesn't matter. Java it doesn't matter. Here tab, and we generally specify not a tab. It should be either 2 character or 4 character. Python doesn't say that it should be, cannot be 1 character, but everywhere in Python literature it is always you see the code either 2 character or 4 character, mostly 2 character. So I would request you try to within this framework, because that is the program should look nice, and collective statement should be together, there should be gap and all these things. So that's thing. So program typing is important. Now just quickly describe what is object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming first start with abstraction. So certain things are similar to each other, like I am SRCSR or object of teacher class, and you are a object of like Simran or Sohar, the technique is object of student class, but there are a lot of similarities are there. The similarities, we can put it in some abstract class, a human. And we can some extend class, teacher class and student class, and the class is a template. Class is not an object. We have to differentiate what is the difference between class and object. Object is the instantiation, like SRCSR is an instantiation of teacher class, and you are an instantiation of student class. So best thing is first thing is come abstraction. Abstraction means there may not be any object to be created by human, so it is abstract class. We created a teacher class, which we can create an object. So that is a little bit idea of abstraction. Then encapsulation comes. These are the very most important things. Whenever we see the commonality of the features, we put it in a class, and which is say the differentiating from one each other. Then we extend the class. So base class, Python, we see within first bracket, we'll see to it, and encapsulation give you lots of data security. Now, what are the problem with C is there is no security in the data. Everything is almost public. So we'll see that what is encapsulation, and then the inheritance. Inheritance I already told you, like whenever a base class is human, we are creating another class, teacher class or another class, in student class. So in that is import reusability is the main feature, and polymorphism, it is the toughest idea. We'll discuss it. Polymorphism means in C, if you have to write a different name function which can handle different types of objects. Say if you want to add two integers, so you have to make a function add int, parameter maybe two integers, and add float, parameter maybe two floating point number. But polymorphism here, the advantage is you can use the same name, and implementation depends on what are the parameters are passed. So that is great about polymorphism. Whole object-oriented programming depends on polymorphism. So that's it. So object-oriented programming, it comes later. The C comes, you already know, in 1961, and Python came in 1990, and Java comes 4 years later, 94-95. Python is not purely object-oriented. It has a mix of procedural programming and object-oriented programming. Java purely on object-oriented programming, like this. C++ has a both advantage, is a procedural programming and object-oriented programming. So still now C++ is one of the favorite language. So that is not C, C++. Java is also a very good language. But one negative point of Java is barbarous. You have lots of code, and Java is ruled by a particular one company, that is Oracle. Advantage of Python is all the people are working on Python, like Google, like Microsoft, because it's like C++, it is an open source. That's it. So that is the reason what is object-oriented programming. Now we go to the next slide. That is, I already told you, the class is basically template. Class is a template. This object-oriented programming, some of the attributes. These attributes kinds of a variables, but one thing is, these variables can be private, can be public, and these variables should be private, and this should be manipulated. Like you want to say height generally not increased, weight can be increased. Say maybe after COVID, there may be a weight increase. Hobbies you can add, and all these things. Height, yeah, in an adolescent period, height, okay, you can also increase. So you can manipulate these attributes by a methods. Those methods can be public methods or private methods. Generally, you can see the public methods. So you always change the attributes by the public methods. Public method, you can access it from the outside of the outside area. So I've told you the teacher class. This is the name of the teacher, say SSC. Like this, these are the methods. So you must understand what are the method attributes and what are the methods. Methods are verbs basically, and here is the nouns basically. We'll come to this. So what is the main thing in object-oriented programming? First thing is abstraction, then comes the encapsulation. They comes generally together, and then comes the inheritance. Without any one of them, it will not be object-oriented programming. Can you tell him that I am telling? Because say without any inheritance. Without inheritance means you have to create every class by itself from the scratches. That is not object-oriented programming. That is not good, because you have to see the commonality of the classes and make a base class. That base class can be abstract class. We are not creating any object out of it. So that is it. So inheritance is a must. Inheritance is a must. Abstraction is a must. Encapsulation, I have told you, because all the variables should be your insight. Say you have seen in old YOLO taxi, probably you have seen the two wiper. Most of the private taxis, YOLO taxis, you see instead of two wipers, you can see one wiper. Because whenever they generally don't keep in a garage. Garage is too costly for them. They generally put it on a roadside in front of their neighborhood. And the wipers are generally being stolen very easily, because that is a public access. You cannot see a steering is a steering is stolen, because steering is a private, because it is within a taxi with a lock and key. Anything outside, in that you can see tires is also public, because tires is accessible from the outside. Anybody can steal a tire, but the tire is a lot of noise and this thing can be generated. But any wiper can be stolen within 1 minute. So that is the reason you see one wiper is only one wiper. They are working on the driver side wiper. That is an example of the public variable. So you should not have your program. You make a program such a way that you should not have a global variable. Like in C, you have a concept of global variable. In Python also, global variable concept is there for ease of programming, but that is not recommended. And that is, you should have the variables, all variables should be private, and try to, then you can ask if the private variables are private, how to manipulate. Then you need a method for any accessing that variable. That method can be public. So that way, anybody wants to change a particular variable, you can always ask the, what is the username, password, like a challenge response type. So that is it. So these are all very important. Class is a template. Polymorphism, I have already told you, the name can be same, but it depends on the object, and ultimately that depends on the class, how we implemented the method at the class level. Remember, the all implementation level is at the class level, not at the object level. And there are two kinds of variables. One is a class variable, that is a single copy for all object, and another is object variables. Every object has its own copy of variables. So two types of variables that can be public, private, but it is recommended private, and all the variables should be manipulated by methods. And we do not call functions here. In C generally we call functions, but in Python, Java, we always call the method, and we call it the public methods or private methods. We come to that. A private method can be called by a public method. So sometimes more security things and all these things, we can put it in a private method, and that private method will be called by another public method. If it is not called by another public method, there is no use of that method. Okay, so that's it. So there is a usefulness of public method, private method. We'll come to this. So here it is, say in Python, we always declare this is a class, is a keyword. This is, you see, I am this class child, and base class is parent. So it is not shown here the genetically like thing, but you can see the child has a first name, last name from parent. So it is a parent is a base class, and extended class is child. Okay, so this is inheritance comes into picture. Okay, so here you see the class, as I have told you, is a pattern or template. There is no object out of it. It can be abstract. And this is the constructor, that is, whenever an object is created, only one times that constructor is called. And in Java, the constructor and class name are the same. Those who know Java, and here it is simple, it is underscore, underscore, init, underscore, underscore. That's the difference. We'll come to it. In Java, in the same type of variable within the class is called by a this operator. And here it is the self operator. And so this is the, so there are some similarities between, very similarities between Java and Python. We'll see this. So this is the constructor, underscore, underscore, init, underscore, underscore. Whenever you see the any variable name is underscore, underscore, that means that it is a, that is a very special kind of method. Here, we are, you see this object-oriented programming. So these are the properties. So I have told you only the variables or properties are the same. So you can change the color of this car. So color is a property. Year, which year you have it is manufactured, price, these are all the properties. These are the, you can call it the nouns. And these are the methods, the verbs, like drive, park, like this. And there is another type of things in events. If you start the car, you first make your opening the driver's seat and then the ignition, then put it from neutral to first gear, then first gear to second gear. These are the methods we have been mentioned in the on start, on park. Whenever you are parking your vehicle, it should be on neutral, and your brake should be, handbrake should be on, like this. On braking, you should put brake and clutch together. So these are the uneven. So this object-oriented programming, this thing can be done. In procedural programming, these properties are all mainly public. There is methods, you called it a function, and events that cannot be done, it is a kind of functions too. So here we segregate these properties. So this is much easier to understand, so easier to maintain, more security, because your properties cannot be changed because it is more secure, because all are private variables. So the object-oriented programming generally give a code may be larger, maybe ultimate running code larger, but it's a more secure code. So that is the reason whenever your code runs at many places, many where, we prefer object-oriented programming from Java or Python, not code on C. The one negative point of C is C cannot be run on any machine, because C machine, you know, object output and A dot out, it is not portable. But here, Python and Java, the advantage is the running on a virtual machine. So that is great. So I have told you that the base class, you can have that maybe a abstract class, and there may be extended class, wheeled vehicle, there may be another class, you can give either different types of sedan, all these things can be a great advantage. So whatever the real level picture in the real world, you can visualize it in your programming framework. So your testing, your coding, your distributing of work, because any code is not done by a single coder. So whenever you are designing a code, like a development of Windows 11, it may require maybe 1,000 programmers, and it may have the codes of previous 10 years code of say 50,000 programmers. This Windows 11 is coming, it should be good, feedback is good, but this is generally done in object-oriented programming, because the coder is huge, and like there, even there is bugs will be there, but you have proven that Windows 10 is much better than Windows 7. Windows 7 sometimes you give the blue screen, but Windows 10 is really good. And it run, one great thing about Windows 10 and similarly Linux also, it can be run on any types of machine, any kind of, whether it's the Intel or this. This is a great operating system. Okay. So this is, I already, just a minute. Yeah. So this is, you've all understood, the person, it can be a basic class. Another example is the patient and the physician. Yes, this is, say, another example like Pokemon. So these are the variables, or you can call the attributes. These are the called attributes, and these are the methods. So these are the called attributes, sometimes the variables, and these attributes should be private, not public. So this is the class like this. Yeah, another way is object identifiable characteristics, so like this. These are the attributes, and these are the another objects, the methods. And there is another type of methods we have already known, that on event startup, like this, is event. So both are the methods, two kinds of methods. One is event oriented. So this is procedural programming. Basically, here more emphasis given on your CPU power, programmer's part, and everything is like function one, function two. And object-oriented programming, one good thing is it can be distributed over many CPUs, and it can be hidden, functions can be hidden. They talk with each other with messages. And here, the all complexities comes here mainly, and the program can be bigger and bigger. Here the complexities are distributed, just a minute. Here the complexities are distributed, you can test it. This class or object separately, and here you have to test it. So program size will be procedural programming, maybe less, definitely it will be less, but maintaining this procedural programming is will be tougher. Object-oriented programming, lot of advantages given. Okay. So this is in a nutshell advantage of Python over Java. So you all know that Java uses indentation, doesn't use indentation, only semicolon. Here uses the Java uses the semicolon, here doesn't use the semicolon, it is indentation, the white space. So that is, so you have to force indentation your programming lines, so you can see your program and visualize your program much better in Python, because it will force you. If you cannot make the indentation correct, If you don't make that, then program would not run. So whenever you have copy paste from some other code, so you have to indent yourself. That is a great thing. If you try it, if you copy paste from another program, indentation may not be copied because there's a tab. So you have to, again, you have to put certain things. So you have to knowingly indent the code inside you. That is one good thing I found in Python. And here, simple like plain English, more focus on the task. Yes, Python programmers are type fewer lines, so less syntax errors. That's it. Python is definitely slower than Java, but great advantage is the third-party libraries. Where here only the JDK libraries. The Python, you dream it, you take it. Everything is available in Python right now. If with a what I can say, you can see any application you can run on your desktop with the Python, and that everything is there. You want to make your camera, video camera wise, you can make your sound or anything you can take. So that's a Python's advantage, and it's a free, it's less code. Only thing, it's a bit slower, but the development time, because it's quicker, so you can quickly come to the market very fast. That is not possible in Java. So programming, finishing it takes it. So you can make your prototype with Python very easily. Then later on, you can shift to Java and mix up Python and Java. That is possible. This is object-oriented programming. Say, I've said this is abstract class. This is a class. This is this is a base class. It's abstract. So that is the reason it's called abstract. You can see this is called UML diagram. You can see in your next unified modeling language. So by looking at this, you know this is abstract and this is optional. And this, whenever you see concrete square or then concrete rectangle, that means it's a really implemented class. So in one good thing about object-oriented programming, that you don't have to put every methods to be concrete. So if you do not put, you just name the method, you don't declare it, you declare it, but don't make put your body into it, then it is an abstract class. It's good in C++, Java, Python, and this is same. So you just make the basic framework ready, then whenever you need, you elaborate on that framework. That is not allowed in procedural programming. That is in object-oriented programming that is allowed. So this is it. I think I have already described, this is the car attributes and this is the car methods. Another is events. So methods and events are almost like sync. So it is basically nouns, it is basically verb. This is object-oriented programming. Yes, this is this is a procedural-oriented programming, POP. Don't take it as a POP push. Procedural-oriented programming, object-oriented programming. Here, in procedural programming, everything in your, if you say a function, it is all are here. There is no characters, private or public or like this. And C, everybody is equal. But in object-oriented programming, you can make these variables default private. So, but it requires the code size will be bigger, ultimate code size. Whenever you are getting from IDE, code size will be bigger, but it is much secure. The programming can be maintained very well. So Java and C++ and Python follow this. This are the main difference. In procedural programming, program is divided into small part called functions. And remember, we don't call function here. We call it objects, class, and methods. So here Python's a mix of both. Python has both these. That is one of the good reasons of Python. So certain programs, say in a numerical analysis program, and then have lots of numerical analysis, then it is better to have a procedural programming. But one transaction oriented program, like ATM transaction, lots of messages to be passed, the transaction like e-commerce, like B2B, B2C, e-commerce, whenever you are communicating, like YouTube, Facebook, they can be developed in object-oriented programming. But whenever you are done, we are doing any purely numerical analysis for a weather forecasting allowed, then the procedural programming. So in a particular program, you might need both type of things. Then the Python comes to help. And C++ can also help. C++ has both features, but Python is libraries are available. In C++, libraries are available, but it can be only C++ library. But Python, you can get many third-party libraries, and mainly libraries are developed in C++. Like in NumPy, like you all know, Python doesn't have array features, but you can quickly get it the array features by NumPy. So that is, you can include import NumPy as NP. That is NumPy library is developed in C++ mainly. Yeah, so this is a procedural programming. Here you are creating like kind of a class kind of things. The nearest template in C to class is a struct or union. But I personally do not find any use of union, because union, whenever it was developed by Dennis Ritchie and Cunningham back in 1961, at that time memory is very costly thing. Right now memory is cheaper. So basic utility of union is your actual data size should be a union. That means the maximum of all together. But here, or maximum or minimum, you can see it is basically union gives the which way it takes care of the size should be shorter. But there is no use right now union. Basically struct is more useful. Your struct is, you can think of as a class, abstract class type, the nearest approximation. Procedural programming is what needs to be done. Object-oriented programming mainly focus on data. So advantage is when your program complexity, if you put certain things comes on a data, and whenever you have your Python, you have a various kinds of data type, like other than array, you have a list, you have a tuple, difference of list and tuple, you know, tuple, the size is fixed so that it can be manipulated easy. It can be indexed to a dictionary. Dictionary is a certain things, key value pair, the same key values you can add, and key values should not be duplicate, but the value can be duplicated. So you can look up anything by a dictionary. That's a unique advantage, even not C++ and Java doesn't give. So lots of advantages of dictionary and tuple, set, frozen set. These make it up. So your actual programming will be shorter, and all these things supported by your Python virtual machine. So your programming will be quicker, smaller in size, readable. Unlike Java, it is shorter, like English language. So that's great. So here it is a C++. Yeah, that I have told you, that noun versus verb. So it is a more object-oriented programming or style of writing the program, and this is procedural programming. Whatever you taught in your currently earlier class, in your maybe now the data structure class, you are learning how to write C, but the more focus you are stressing on the program, when in Python you have a lot of supports are there, so you can write easily your system quickly. Yeah, so this is a basically in object-oriented programming. An object is object, it's come from a class, and these are the methods. It can be public methods, it can be private methods. I have shown it here mostly public, but it can be possible a private method. So this method, this can be called outside, this can be called by the in-house method. So this method can be public method. This public method can call this private method. You can ask why I can put it there, but this private method can be called by this public method also. So certain things you can more encapsulated, more checking into a private method. Remember, private method cannot be called from outside, and you want to make all the private data, it can be manipulated only the public method. So what are the advantage? You cannot by the dot operator like C, you cannot increase this dot. Everything is br open. Here everything is you have to manipulate through methods, the function calls. Whenever a method is called, it can check username, password and all these things, and so that's it. It's a more secure thing. So because security is a premium here, so that's it. Yeah, and another, you know, C++, the problem with the pointer. Python and Java doesn't have pointer, so you can directly cannot access the code, so that way it's a more secure. Here it is a Python declaration of constructor. I've told you, so it is it is a special method. How do you know special method? Double underscore. The special method self, I have told you this example, like a D surface Java. Self means self dot radius means I am pointing to the radius of this. This is a, I am pointing self dot radius is radius. So you are passing the values whenever you are creating object. The radius is 5, color is red, then this will be 5 and this will be red. So that's it. This is how to the class addition. Here is the constructor. So in Java, the constructor will be the same name, addition, but here in Python it will be this self num1 num2. It is num1 and if I am all the methods I get, this is a method, is a public method. I am writing this now. I am